mind by the time the emergency got there. Well, they live on top of the mountain at Fort Clinton, and we're the closest emergency.
Allison's ringing the bell. Do you need someone to
learn? No, I have with him. Molly's doing it.
Well, they scrub, I know they, you know, the manager tells them, you can go to practice, somebody starts beating, she's a well. She's run up now.
Good morning. Welcome to St. John's United Church of Christ here in Orwigsburg, Pennsylvania. My name is Tom Kramer. I serve on the Stewardship Commission and I'm also Vice President of Consistory. Anyone who's visiting with us this morning, we'd like you to sign our guest book in the narthex, and we hope you enjoy your visit with us, and we invite you to visit anytime in the future. Just a couple of quick things. Obviously, we'll be able to follow the service on the screens, but one of the things you probably noticed, the offering plates are no longer at the entrances. That's because we will take offering in the pews today. If you have a cell phone, you might want to turn it down, turn it off, so it doesn't go off during the service. There will be Sunday school after the children's message. We will have a coffee hour at the conclusion of the service. Coffee hour, Parish Life is always looking for sponsors. I believe there's a board over there in the large Sunday school room where you can sign up. Our charity of the month is OCWM, our church's wider mission. That will run for the whole month of February. And if you want to give after the month is up, that's perfectly fine. People do that. The last thing I want to say is there's a sign-up sheet back there in Bill Holler's technology table. We need helpers. We need people to help us run the church. There's opportunities for greeters, for ushers, for people to come and read the scripture, to help in Sunday school, not necessarily teach Sunday school, but just to help. Sponsor a coffee hour, all the things that make St. John St. John's. So we need people to be active and to help. Are there any announcements from the congregation? Yes, Kay.
So two things about OCWM. I believe on the envelopes, you may have a checkoff box that John is on the website, I don't know. But you can put the OCWM contributions in your regular envelope, and if it's not on the outside of the box of the envelope, you can just write OCWM and the amount. The other thing is that 17 of us were trained last week in CPR and how to use our AED and some pretty amazing first aid things. So we're attacked by various things to know exactly what to do. But we do have a thank you card here. The gentleman who did it was a police officer from Orwigsburg, and he was wonderful, absolutely wonderful. We spent 3 hours with him, and it was just a whole lot of fun. But so any of the 17, if you're here this morning, we have a card over here to send to him. We'll send it out with a check with the American Heart Association. So please sign the thank you card.
Yes, Susan.
Good morning. I'm going to roll in a joy because then I won't stand up twice. The candy that we always send to our college students and our military members have gone out. So remember that in February we always try to do that through Parish Life. So that is a joy. In 2 weeks, we're going to have a soup sale here after church. $8 a quart. We need people to make soup, and we need people to stop over and buy soup. So please remember that on March 5th. Thank you.
If you noticed on the monitor screen, the food pantry gave out 112 boxes. They also had 10 walk-ins. Now, if you don't know what a walk-in is, those are people that come directly to the food pantry, pick up a box, and take it home. They're able to be close enough that they can walk. Others come and get a cart on the day of distribution, and they walk their cart all day, all the way down the roadway, and they stop at all the stations to get the things that have donated for them.
Thank you, Ruth. Others from the congregation? Okay, Pastor Jeff, your turn.
Good to be with you this morning. It's a beautiful day because we're here together in the presence of God. And I look forward to our worship service today. A few things to mention, both of them are this upcoming Wednesday. I wonder what's happening Wednesday. For one thing, we have our Bible study at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. That will go on as usual. We're beginning a study of the book of 1 Peter in the New Testament. 1 Peter chapter 1. So you can go home and do your reading in preparation for that, whether you can be there or not. We'd love to see you, though, if you are able to do that. Also, Wednesday evening at 7 o'clock, we will together usher in the season of Lent. Ash Wednesday, this week, 7 o'clock, it is a quiet and solemn service of repentance, and you will have the opportunity to receive ashes in your forehead, in your hand, whatever you would like, on Wednesday night. I hope you can make it. Thank you.
Let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship.
Oh,
there is any joy in sharing this morning, I'm going to say right away, my joy, one of them, is that all of you folks are with us on Facebook, watching and participating in our service today. Leave a little message, say hello, so we know you were here, and we will register your attendance. Is there a joy? Anyone else would like to share? Yes.
I have a joy. Isabel Rose is 97 today.
Nature has sent a message that spring is on the way because the daffodils are up on the church property.
Well, we're very happy that the cost is back in church today. And Stephanie is on the road to the power.
Stand for a call. For God called to Moses from the mountain.
We are called to be God's people.
And Jesus called the disciples to climb with him to the peak of another mountain.
We are called to follow wherever he leads.
And the disciples stood in awe at the sound of God's voice.
We are called to worship and wonder and praise.
Let us pray. Dear God, may the light of your love and presence shine brightly into our midst this day as we have taken the time to gather in worship. Bring out your great purpose for our church, for our lives as individuals, as we sing and pray and listen to your voice this morning. Amen. And our prayer of confession, you will join me. Lord, you call us to draw near, yet we fail to hear your voice. We sleepwalk through life, ignoring the needs of people all around us, and worrying about our own desires. Forgive us when we shut out the call to climb into your presence, when we make excuses to put off that journey. Have mercy on us, O Lord, as we silently open our hearts and confess our sins. Please, O God, and lift us in newness of life. Amen. Friends, we worship a forgiving God, whose mercy is never ending, whose heart abounds in steadfast love. And because of the love of Jesus Christ, nothing is separated from the love of God.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. You may be seated. And do we know what comes forward for us?
You heard part of our scripture reading when you read the call to worship. Listen, and you'll know what I'm talking about. The first reading is from Exodus chapter 24, verses 12 to 18. The Lord said to Moses, "Come up to me on the mountain and wait there, and I will give you the tablets of stone with the law and the commandment which I have written for their instruction." So Moses set out with his assistant Joshua, and Moses went up into the mountain of God. To the elders he had said, "Wait here for us until we come to you again. For Aaron and Hur are with you. Whoever has a dispute may go to them." Then Moses went up on the mountain, and the cloud covered the mountain. The glory of the Lord settled on Mount Sinai, and the cloud covered it for 6 days. On the seventh day, he called to Moses out of the cloud. Now the appearance of the glory of God was like a devouring fire on top of the mountain, in the sight of the people of Israel. Moses entered the cloud and went up on the mountain. Moses was on the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights. Our New Testament lesson is from the book of Matthew, chapter 17, verses 1 to 13. 6 days later, Jesus took with him Peter and James and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his face shone like the sun, and his clothes became dazzling white. Suddenly, there appeared to them Moses and Elijah, talking with him. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you wish, I will make 3 dwellings here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While he was still speaking, suddenly a bright cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud a voice said, "This is my Son, the Beloved. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him." When the disciples heard this, they fell to the ground and were overcome by fear. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, "Get up and do not be afraid." When they looked up, they saw no one except Jesus himself alone. As they were coming down the mountain, Jesus ordered them, "Tell no one about the vision until after the Son of Man has been raised from the dead." And the disciples asked him, "Why then do the scribes say that Elijah must come first?" He replied, "Elijah is indeed coming and will restore all things. But I tell you that Elijah has already come, and they did not recognize him, but they did to him whatever they pleased. So also the Son of Man is about to suffer at their hands." Then the disciples understood that he was speaking to them about John the Baptist. Here end the scripture readings for the morning. Blessed are they who hear the word of God and keep it in their hearts.
come up and have a seat over here, nearby, here, in front, for a few minutes.
Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He descended to heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life of the everlasting. Amen. You may be seated. Speaking of powerful things, gratitude for God's power, presence, and blessing in our life is also a powerful thing. We now offer back to God a little bit of what God has given us through our tithes and offerings, and will the ushers please come forward. Thank you to all who pray. We all pray. We're developing that habit of regular prayer. And perhaps listening to God as well. As I mentioned recently, that's one thing that I'm working on, is just be silent before God. But there are many that have requested our prayers, and there are
Arlington, our community, and our world in need of God's hope and help this day. We pray for the people in Ukraine and continue to do that over a year now for their well-being in the midst of a very trying time and a very difficult war that's being fought on their land. I'd like to mention a couple of prayer needs that I'm aware of, and then just offer the opportunity if there are any others this morning before we pray. Peters have asked prayers for the family and the friends of George Rigby, who passed away this last Sunday, the 12th. We offer prayers for him, for his family, friends, and for all who have lost loved ones recently. Also, the prayers for a good recovery for Glenn Franz, who had surgery to remove some colon cancer just this past week, and he is now recovering and in some pain, but doing otherwise well at this point. So, are there any others this morning who you might mention before prayer? Yes, sir.
Can we keep in our prayers the people of East Palestine, Ohio, and in western Pennsylvania, the chamber railings contaminated with water and air, caused a lot of problems there.
So, the people that are dealing with the aftermath of that awful train wrecked East Palestine, Ohio, for their health and well being, and for the health that they need.
Also, for the people of Turkey from the tremendous earthquake, all the lives were lost.
People from southwest Turkey and parts of Syria suffered a huge earthquake a couple weeks ago, and nowhere near digging out from that. It's a major catastrophe. So, prayers for them as well. Thank you. And if there are no others, let's go to God. We offer our prayers this day of thanksgiving for you, gratitude for life, prayers for health and hope in times of need. Times of grief, times of worries and care, times of pain, times of surgery, preparing for and recovering from. For those that are dealing with cancer in any way, shape, or form this day, that challenge might be lived with your help and your healing spirit in God. And for the people in our world that are so challenged in so many ways, in addition to Ukraine, we think of East Palestine, Ohio, people suffered following that train wreck and the dangers of that, and the folks who have gone through a tremendous earthquake and have so far to go in that recovery. May your spirit be bring hope and comfort and into our lives. We need you every day through Christ who taught us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Our debts, as we forgive our debts. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
presence of God's Spirit to worship this day and as you prepare to leave this place. May you know that the Spirit goes with you and the opportunity to live, love, and serve as followers of Jesus will also come to you for sure. Now may the Lord be with you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance, his face, to you, always giving you peace until we meet again.